Okay. So now listen. So in the first step, we have successfully converted acyl CoA into what is this? This is trans enoyl CoA. Trans enoyl CoA. Why it is trans? Now listen with all your attention. Why it is always trans? You can understand. Now listen. First thing you need to understand again is, if there is a cis product, then it is again converted into trans enoyl CoA. Why? Because there is a reason for it. Because the next enzyme which will be acting upon this particular substrate. Now this is the substrate for this enzyme. For the next enzyme, this is the substrate. Now the second enzyme which will be acting on this particular substrate only works when there is trans configuration in this particular substrate. That's why. Okay. Now, what is the next step? Hydration. Hydration means what? Hydration means addition of water, right? Addition of water. That means again you will have to add water here. Okay, you will have to add water here. Now, you know there is something called Markovnikov's rule. If you don't know, then go back to my videos, you will understand on organic chemistry what is Markovnikov's rule. Now listen, following Markovnikov's rule, what will happen is, a very easy thing. Anyone who is a big, you know, anyone who is a moderate level, anyone who knows moderate level chemistry can understand what is going on. It is nothing but a product obtained using Markovnikov's rule. Okay, now listen. You need to understand that this, from this, we are getting this particular substrate product, right? Now listen. What is happening is, actually these carbons were present in sp2 hybridization, right? sp2 hybridization, and now these carbons are present in sp3 hybridization. That means what? That means pi bond, one of the pi bond is broken and two sigma bonds are produced. That means from pi bond, suppose we get 30, you know, kilojoule, suppose we get 30 kilojoule of energy from one pi bond, by breaking one pi bond, but we will have to establish two sigma bonds, right? We will have to establish two sigma bonds here, one for OH and another for H, right? That means, suppose for each and every, you know, suppose for each and every sigma bond, we need 60 kilojoule. That means, we directly need 120 kilojoule of, sorry, this is not kilojoule, it's joule. 120 joule of energy here, suppose. I may be wrong with the units, but still you need to understand this concept. Suppose you need 120 joule of energy to create these bonds, and by breaking the pi bonds you have got only 60 kilojoule, suppose 60 joule. That means what? That means you will have to invest extra 60 joule. That means in this particular reaction you need energy from outside sources. That is the exact definition of endothermic process. So this is an endothermic process going on here. Okay, now listen, what is the enzyme which is acting here? Listen, the name of this enzyme is 2,3 enoyl hydratase. Okay. So now we have successfully converted trans 2 enoyl CoA to 3 hydroxy acyl CoA. Okay,
3 hydroxy acyl CoA. This is
3 hydroxy acyl CoA.
Now this is the, you know, first step, step 1.
This is the first step and this is the second step, that is hydration. Now again
an oxidation will occur. Listen with all your attention. Again an oxidation will occur here. Okay, listen.
Again an oxidation will occur here. This time this oxidation is much more different with respect to oxidation number 1. Why, you know? Listen.
In case 1, that is in the step 1, there was oxidation. In the step 3, there was oxidation also. But listen with all your attention. In case of step,
this is step 2. In case of step 3, the oxidation is quite different. Why, you know? Because in step 3, what will happen is, you need to understand here. Hydrogen will obviously come out from same carbon. That means these two hydrogens will come out here. Okay, these two hydrogens will come out and the product will be okay. That means a keto group has been established in this particular structure, a keto group. Okay. Now, when we remove this hydrogen had lower delta G, but these two hydrogens have very much good energy. Why? Very good, excellent, because you don't know the basic chemistry. This hydrogen is associated with oxygen, that's why it is polar. That's why we need much more stronger, you know, reducing agent. That means what? What is the most stronger reducing agent?
NAD.
Yes, we need NAD. Okay.
Now, what is the enzyme which we will use here for oxidation? Listen, don't worry about this. This is again dehydrogenase. This is again dehydrogenase. What is the name of this product? 3 hydroxy acyl CoA dehydrogenase. Simple. Okay. Okay. Now the final step is thiolase or thiolytic cleavage, which is also known by the name of thiolytic cleavage. Okay, before, you know, before we go on with this step, thiolytic cleavage, you should understand two things. That is, what is a thiol group and how this can be broken down to give an acetyl CoA and an acyl CoA. What is the exact use of that enzyme which will convert this compound into acetyl CoA and acyl CoA? Okay, listen. Okay, so this is the actual, you know, third step. Now we are heading towards the fourth step. Now listen. Now, before I convert this into acetyl CoA and acyl CoA, I will at first draw the structure of acetyl CoA. Listen, this is the structure of acetyl CoA. Okay, now listen. Oh, I have done a mistake. Oh my god, every time. Sorry. Every time there should be no O. That's it. Okay, there should be no O in between S, CoA, and C. Now listen. So, this is, if I tell you, this is the structure of acetyl CoA. This is the actual structure of acetyl coenzyme A. Okay. Now, point you need to understand is, don't you think that acetyl CoA more or less resembles this with an additional H? That's it. That is, acetyl CoA more or less resembles this with an additional H. That's it. Now, listen. From this we will get to here, right? Now listen, what will remain is this part, right? Now listen, suppose if I tell you that we will get this, if I tell you that we will get this and this, that is, this is the acyl CoA. Okay, this is the acyl CoA. This is the acyl CoA and this is the acetyl CoA. Now listen, if I say that you will be getting these two, now listen, whenever I'm telling you will be getting acetyl CoA, that means already S CoA is added, right? Here it is. Now, from where does this come from? This is coming from outside. Okay, this is coming from outside. Okay, coming from outside. And what is the name of this? Listen, the name of this enzyme which is actually helping in the breakdown of this is known by the name of beta keto thiolase. Beta keto thiolase. Okay. So this is the actual fourth step. Okay. Now, somebody was asking that there is a step in between, you know, I will talk about that. Somebody was asking that what is the step between, you know, suppose you want to add S CoA to a fatty acid, then you need ATP. For what reason? Listen, I will be talking about this thing now. Listen, so we have done these things. Okay, we'll now talk about the calculations, and before that I will try to, you know, answer your question. Listen, that is, someone has told an important point, that is, there is a need of ATP when we are converting a fatty acid into fatty acyl CoA, where ATP is used. Listen, suppose you want to convert this fatty acid into fatty acyl CoA, what is the use of ATP? Listen, the main concept you need to understand is, actually, ATP at first binds with a fatty acid. Okay, ATP actually at first binds with this fatty acid. This is step one. Okay, this is step one. And in the next step, this fatty acyl AMP is converted into fatty acyl CoA. In the next step, this fatty acyl AMP is converted into fatty acyl CoA by removing AMP from it. Okay, so this is the second step. Okay, so this is the importance of ATP in converting fatty acid into fatty acyl CoA. Okay, now we will be talking about calculations related to beta oxidation of fatty acid. What do we mean by calculations? Listen. When we were discussing beta oxidation of fatty acid, we have got one FADH2 and one NADH plus H plus. And we know that whenever FADH2 enters electron transport system, then it is converted into two ATP, and when NADH plus and H plus enters electron transport system, then it is converted into 3 ATP, right? Now listen with all your attention. We will, you know, utilize these things to understand some basic things or basic calculations, but before that we need some basic, you know, formulas. You know, this will help you in calculating the number of ATP you will be getting when a 14 number carbon fatty acid is beta oxidized, or a 16th number carbon, that is palmitic acid, is oxidized, or stearic acid, which is 18 carbon. So in exams you are given that stearic acid undergoes beta oxidation. Calculate total number of ATP. Okay, many people just don't understand that learning beta oxidation pathway is not enough. You will have to understand the formulas also. Okay, so now we will be talking about these formulas, that is, that falls under calculation part. Okay, listen, understand these basic three formulas. These are very easy formulas, believe me or not, it's true. Understand these basic three formulas, you will be able to solve every problem on this earth related to beta oxidation. Listen, what are these formulas? Listen, suppose I have given you, calculate the total number of ATP produced when we completely oxidize stearic acid using beta oxidation. Now listen, stearic acid is 18 carbon. Okay, now listen, first step you will have to do is, you have to calculate, step one is you have to calculate the number of acetyl CoA produced. How to calculate? Listen, number of acetyl CoA is equals to number of carbon atoms, in fatty acid divided by 2. That's it. First step you will have to do is, you have to calculate number of acetyl CoA. So I am taking the example of stearic acid. So for stearic acid, number of acetyl CoA is equals to 18 divided by 2, that is 9. Now 9 acetyl CoA is now produced. Now listen with all your attention. Now the main point you will have to understand is, 1 acetyl CoA is equals to, when 1 acetyl CoA enters Krebs cycle,
it will yield 12 ATP. That's it. You will understand this first. One acetyl CoA when enters Krebs cycle yields 12 ATP. Listen. So the total number of ATP produced, from acetyl CoA is equals to number of acetyl CoA into 12. That's it. That means in this case 12 into 9, that means what? 108. Excellent. 108 ATPs are produced. Now if you do up to this, then it's wrong. Why? Listen, this was the step one. That means in step one, at first you will have to calculate the number of acetyl CoA. Okay, then after that calculate the number of ATP produced from total number of acetyl CoA. This is the first step. Okay, so first step has two stages. Okay, two sub stages, stage A and stage B. Okay, let's talk about step two. Listen, you should always understand that step two is actually calculation of NADPH and FADH to produce. Listen, calculate the number of NADH and FADH2 produced. How to calculate this? Listen, number of NADH or FADH2 produced. Okay, it will create confusion. Listen, number of NADH produced during beta oxidation is equal to number of acetyl CoA minus 1. That means in the given example, number of acetyl CoA is 9 minus 1. That means 8 NADH. Wait, there is still more to it. Listen, this is the first stage of step 1. So this is the first stage of step one. Now listen, in the second stage, you will have to understand number of NADH is equals to number of FADH2. That means here FADH2 equals to 8 FADH2. Now you can easily calculate 1 NADH equals to 3 ATP. 1 FADH2 is equals to how many ATP? 2 ATP. That means in case of stearic acid, how many NADPH were there? In stearic acid, in case of stearic acid, there are 8 into 3, what? ATP, right? NADH, in case of stearic acid, FADH2 will be 8 into 2, right? ATP, right? That means 8 is 24, 8 to the 16, that will be equivalent to what? 40. That means 40 ATP you are getting from NADH2 and FADH2 and 108 from acetyl CoA.
Therefore, total, this is the step 3, total ATP is equal to 108 plus 40, that is 148 ATPs. Okay. Now listen, at your home, go and practice this whole thing with palmitic acid, which has 16 carbon. Okay. Answer will be 131 ATPs. Okay. Now, next day we'll be discussing something 131. The answer will be 131. Okay. So today up to this, next day we'll discuss glycogenolysis.